Hi, I'm Scott Kelly, commander of the Expedition 26 crew aboard the International Space Station. What I wanted to try to do today is give you a sense for what our situation is on board with regards to food and beverages, how we prepare that, what options we have, and how we eat here in space. So the first thing I'd like to do is get started with where our food is kept. The food that we're actually using is kept in Node 1 of the space station, and it's basically in these food containers, metal food containers, or in some bags that we have here staged for our use. But these food containers are categorized in different categories, I guess you'd say, and we have some that are side dishes, meats in pouches and cans, vegetables, and they're actually packaged in different ways. For instance, most of the meat we have and other kind of main dishes are packaged in these green containers, and we heat these up in a small food warmer, and I'll show you what that looks like. But basically, they're little green packages of meat, and in this case, this is beef tips with mushrooms, and we have crawfish etouffee. And these are what's called irradiated food, so they're hit with large doses of radiation to kill any bacteria so they can stay at room temperature and not spoil. There's also some stuff in here that's kind of off the shelf, like this tuna fish that we have. We also have some rehydratable food items. Water is heavy, and I'll talk a little bit about our water later, but they take the water out of the food because it's more efficient to add it once we get on board, and I'll talk about how we make our water here in a little bit. But we have these rehydratable food packages. For instance, here's one. I'll make this for lunch. It's asparagus, and it's in a little plastic container with some dehydrated asparagus. In this case, I'll add 50 milliliters of water to it, and takes 5 to 10 minutes to rehydrate. So with that, I'd like to show you how we prepare this food, how we add water, warm it up, and a little bit about the beverages on board as well. So come join me in the lab where that that's accomplished. Now we're in the U.S. laboratory module, and the first thing I want to show you is how we heat up these green packages of food. And these are a lot like the what's called MREs in the military, meals ready to eat. And a matter of fact, I think they come from the same company that the U.S. military uses. Whereas these other packages are produced at the food lab at the Johnson Space Center. So this is basically, this is our food warmer, and it's basically a suitcase with some heating elements in it, and we could put a number of different food packages in here. Basically, we just close it up and turn it on, and in about 20 minutes that package of food will be warm. So next I want to talk about our how we add water both to our drink packages and to the food packages, and that's also done in the laboratory module on the ceiling. And there's a potable water dispenser there that dispenses both room temperature and hot water. So let's go over there and check that out. So here we are by the potable water dispenser, which is on the ceiling here in the laboratory module of the space station. And We get our water from different places. The resupply vehicles will bring up water. The shuttle makes water as a function of how it produces electricity. But we also get water from the Russian Progress vehicles, and soon from the Japanese and the European resupply vehicles bring up water as well. The other way we get water is we make it ourselves on board from the condensate that is produced in the air due to humidity, and also from our urine. And believe it or not, the water that is produced from our urine actually tastes better than any tap water I've ever tasted in the United States. It's tastes better than the water on the space shuttle. It's really clear, good quality water. So basically we have a way to fill these little packages and introduce certain or specific volumes of both hot and room temperature water. So I'll heat up this or rehydrate this asparagus, and I basically just put it in here. And I normally don't do this from this position. And I'll put 50 milliliters of hot water in there to heat it up. And as you can see, it now has water in it, and it's rehydrating, and this will take 5 to 10 minutes. And then I'll put some water into my drink bag. I'll put 250 milliliters of water in this drink bag for lemonade. Most of the drinks are kind of sweet. Most of the time, I don't drink these sweet drinks. Most of the time, I just drink water or coffee. Okay. Then what we do is just put a straw in here. And the other nice thing we have on board is a very small refrigerator, and it'll cool these drinks up very nicely. And the next thing I want to show you is how we eat this stuff once it's both rehydrated, cooled off in our little fridge, and warmed up in our food warmer. So please join me back in Node 1 around the dinner table where we eat. Back in Node 1, where we generally use as our kitchen or dining area, and I'm going to show you how we eat this food. Obviously, it's in these packages that we have to cut open, and basically we just eat all this stuff right out of the packaging. So I'm going to cut open my beef stew, and as you can see, some of it's trying to escape on me already. I generally will eat these things one at a time, just because it's easier to manage without having to put this stuff down. But as you can see, it doesn't look too bad. It's actually pretty tasty. That was one of my Russian crew members that went by. But it ain't bad.
get along?
Yep, the one in the lab is fine. So, that's the beef stew.
All right, we need an SIC number to dial, and if you don't have, we won't be letting you after this short handover start your PFC.
This isn't the asparagus I made, because the asparagus floated away somewhere. Not sure where it went. I'm sure it'll turn up in a couple of days. And we didn't have any more asparagus, so I made some green beans and mushrooms. So we cut this open and proceeded right out of the end of the package. That was Oleg Skripochka again, going back to the Russian segment. And what I generally do, especially at night while eating dinner, is watch the news. And the ground sends up NBC Nightly News every day except on the weekends. So watch it on the computer. They also send up television shows.
On our broadcast tonight, surprise appearance. Will two presidents do the trick in selling Congress on a tax deal that the current president agreed to? Justice, a long-time drama has come to an end.
Here's the
Elizabeth Smart kidnapped from bed tonight for reaction.
Cold lemonade.
He's in Camilla. How could it have happened, and where was British security?
A little on the sweet side for me, but not too bad.
Are they safe or potentially harmful? Why the government is asking
and
this
also,
question again. Nixon,
we got dessert here. We got various kinds of things to eat for dessert.
Tapes, how he spoke to his own daughter when he thought no one was there.
Some of it is like the package, like the beef stew. Others are rehydratable. And other items are just... in this these individual packages. So here I got dried peaches and some candy coated peanuts.
Your President Barack Obama, you're fighting with Congress over a tax deal, and some of your own people are defecting. So who do you call when you call out the reinforcements? The answer is you call the last Democratic president. The two men burst through the door and into the
like
White
said,
House briefing room before cameras
peaches.
Today. And once Bill Clinton started
and
talking,
candy-coated almonds.
One former Clinton
and,
White House aide put it, it was like 1995 all
I'm gonna
over again. Another said it was as if
select
Clinton
the almonds because they look much better floating around than dried
we
peaches.
We begin here tonight with our chief White House correspondent, Chuck Todd, who witnessed all this in the briefing room. Chuck, good evening.
Well, good evening, Brian. Look, for most of the day today, the tax debate has been dominated by Vermont's independent, self-described socialist senator, Bernie Sanders, who's been speaking on the floor of the United States Senate by himself continuously since about 10:30 this morning. Well, about 4 o'clock today, clearly the White House had had enough. So instead of briefing reporters about President Obama's private meeting with President Clinton, President Obama decided to trot out President Clinton himself to brief reporters. Well, it turned into a de facto ex-presidential press conference.
The agreement taken as a whole is, I believe, the best bipartisan agreement we can reach to help the largest number of Americans and to maximize the chances that the economic recovery will accelerate and create more jobs and to minimize the chances that it will slip back. There's never a perfect bipartisan bill.
Dealing with the garbage here on board is somewhat of a challenge since you don't have the garbage man coming a couple times a week. We actually have to store our trash on board for several months. So it's important that it doesn't take up a whole lot of space. So we already put the green beans in there in this little, kind of in the plastic bag that one of the other food items came in. We also want to get as much of the moisture out of this garbage so it can then be turned back into drinkable water with our system that, that converts the, both the humidity and urine into potable water. So we try to get as much of the moisture out of these stuff as we can. And so I just make sure that, you know, the packages are as dry as possible. And obviously if I drink this, eventually it's going to wind up back in the potable water system versus, you know, coming to a fiery end in the re-entry of one of the progress vehicles that, that carries our garbage. So, get it as basically as dry as possible. And then we separate our wet trash from our dry trash, because the wet trash is, you know, can get more smelly. And so we put our wet trash in these Russian waterproof bags, and one of these will last me, as the only U.S. crew member on board here, well over a week. We'll get this as small as we possibly can, filled up, and eventually it'll go in the progress. The dry trash is stored separately in a long plastic trash bag, but I don't have one of those right here to show you. In any case, hope you enjoyed joining me here for lunch on the International Space Station, and learned a little bit about how we manage and deal with the food and beverages on board. Thanks for joining me today.